Do you want to create viral videos like this similar to Natt Jongsala? In this video, I will show you how to recreate this animation that got over 1 million views for Natt all using Premiere Pro. Normally, it's faster to do this kind of 3D animations in After Effects, but we will be using Premiere Pro, so let's get right into it. For the animation, you will need this kind of images. This PNG files with some gradient and a bit of glow. I will add all these images in the description so that you can just download them and start the edit. But just in case you want to know how to create this kind of images, I'll show them how to do it using Photoshop. So let's open Photoshop first and create a new document. Let's keep the width and height as 1080 by 1080 pixels and click on create. Let me show you how to do this one. Once you know how to create one of them, you will be able to do the other ones easily. So for that, I will just add this vector image. I created it using an AI. You can download it from FreePic as well, or you can create it using AI. If you just write the prompt 2D vector art something something, you can create them easily. Let us cut out the background first of all. For that, we'll select this tool, the quick selection tool here, and click on select subject. Now we'll need to refine the selection. So this part is being unselected, so we'll just hold the left click and drag over to add this part in the selection as well. This portion, we need to clean up the edges. We don't need this white portion in the selection, so we'll just hold alt and drag it over here to unselect this part and this part as well. Clean up the edges a bit. We don't need this person, so we can just press alt and remove everything from here. We can increase the brush size. If you press the bracket button, the third bracket button, and press alt and drag over it to unselect this part. So after the selection is done, we can click here, select and mask, and see if the selection is good or not. Yeah, the selection looks good to me. Let's just turn on the smart radius and click on OK. To mask it out, you just click here on this thing. Let's hide the background layer for now. So in order to see the selection clearly, let's create a layer. Let's create an empty layer, place it below, and select red color here. Select the red color or any other color which is in contrast to the color of the person here. Click on the paint bucket tool. If you can't find it, just hold and click here. Now place the bottom as red. Yeah, this looks pretty fine. It doesn't have to be that clean. If just the overall shape is holding, it should be good. Maybe we can just clean up this part a bit. So for that, we'll just bring up the brush tool, and if you select here this thing, the layer mask, you'll see that the white portion is revealed and the black portion is hidden from the image. Just make sure that it's white here in the left hand side and just drag it over a bit to make it cleaner. You can make any other adjustment if you want, but this should be good for us. Now let's hide the background and select this. Come over here in the blending options and select the gradient overlay. Okay, before that we need to go here, image adjustments, and click on hue saturation. Decrease the lightness first, so make it black totally. Now you have to come here in the blending options and select the gradient overlay. So just like this, I've already selected the color. The devil should be a bit orangish and a bit of red. You can change the angle a bit to get different gradient. Make sure that the gradient is selected as radial, and you can adjust the scale to get a proper. And this looks fine. Now click on OK. Once this is done, click on this button again and add an outer glow. Make sure you select the color from here. Click on OK, and you can keep the settings as it is. The blend mode is normal, opacity 20%, and the spread 5%, size 60 pixels. Or you can just play with these settings and see whatever you feel is good. Now click on OK, and this thing is done. You can do the same stuff with the other images as well. Just make sure to change the colors in the gradient overlay and the outer glow. Now one more thing, you can just add a PNG of the horns over here and do the same thing, and it will do the job. Once the images are created, let us bring them all to Premiere Pro. Let's just create a folder so that they are properly managed. Also, let us bring the reference video as well. So this is the reference video. We'll be editing the first 5 seconds. In order to start, we need to create a sequence first. So we'll come here, click on new item, then click on sequence. In the settings, you can just keep the settings as 1080 by 1920. The frame rate is 24, and rename it to something. Click on okay and we should be good. So from the reference, let's just drag the audio first. So for the audio should be:
the most dangerous people in society are lazy, ambitious people. This,
yeah, it should end around this here. So let's just drag the audio from here like this. You can increase the timeline size by pressing plus on the keyboard, and you can decrease it by pressing minus. Now we just need to bring the images. So let's just go to the first frame of the reference and see. You'll see that the orange person is at the furthest end from the screen. So we'll keep it in the bottom layer here. And then the second one is, should be this, the one sitting. The third one is this guy standing, this one. You need to drag all the images till the end of the audio. But the fourth would be this walking from the left hand side. So we'll just use this image for that. And the last one will be this. Drag it to the top. Now we need to arrange all the images according to the first screen of the reference. So our reference is here, and if you go to the first screen, you'll see the arrangement. Now we just need to arrange them according to this. So let's just arrange the top one for now. Click on this, go to the FX control panel, do the scale and position. We can bring the FX control panel here so that we can see the reference while arranging all the stuff in our sequence here. Yeah, we need to keep the one that is closer to the screen as the largest and slowly decrease the size of each image as we go, and keep the second one a bit smaller than the first one and keep it above the first one like this. If you look at the example, each of them are above, which designates that they are further from the camera. Let's imagine a fake floor over here. So we'll just have to recreate that by using the position and the scale. So once you position them properly, you will see that the screen looks like this, which is quite similar to what we have in the reference over here. Now we just need to start the animation. So to start the animation, we'll animate this one first, and the one that is closer to the camera. So let's just hide everything for now. We'll select this layer, go to the first frame and add some keyframes for position and scale. Now go a few frames forward. Let's see where the animation ends for the first one. Yeah, it ends around the 1 second mark. So we'll go a few frames forward around the 1 second mark, increase the scale a bunch, click on the motion and drag it down like this so that it's out of the screen. Yeah, so that the animation looks like this. Yeah, you can play with the position so that it looks proper. Yeah, let's decrease the volume of this a bit. It's too loud for me. Yeah, if you look at this, it looks good, but it needs to be, the animation needs to be a bit smoother. So for that, you can just select the keyframes, right click, temporal interpolation ease in, right click, temporal interpolation ease out. But the thing is that if we do it like this, with the right click and all, it will take a lot of time since we are doing a bunch of keyframes throughout the video. So I'll just show you a faster way to do this using keyboard shortcuts. Let's just reset the keyframes, and to do it using the keyboard shortcuts, you can just select the keyframes, press F9 to ease in and then F10 to ease out. So it will do the same job as the clicks, but it is a much faster process. Now F9 and F10 will not work for you if you have not set it in the keyboard shortcuts panel. So to set it, you'll come here in the edit and go to keyboard shortcuts. Now if you just search here ease in and come here, you'll see this two, keyboard temporal interpolation, this two. So set the first one, you just press the keyboard, you can set it as the F9, and the second one just press F10 and it will be set as, the first one is the ease in as F9 and the second one will be set as F10, which is the ease out. After you set this, you just click on OK and the keyboard shortcuts will be set. Okay, since the first one is done, let's bring the second one as well and do the animations for her using the same process. And the second one should last on the screen a bit longer than the first one. So yeah, once this one is done, go a few frames forward and then do the scale, select the position and just drag it out like this. Now do the same thing here as well, press F9 and F10. after selecting the keyframes for the ease in and ease out. The second should stay in the screen a bit longer, so you need to adjust the keyframes. Okay, looks good. Similarly, you just bring all the characters on the screen and do the animations. The process is quite the same, so you shouldn't have any issue. Just make sure to keep the keyframes as ease in and ease out, or else the animation won't look smooth.
The most dangerous. People in society.
Yeah, while doing the animation, make sure that they go in the same direction on each side, and make sure that the one which is bigger goes out of the camera faster than the ones which are smaller, that is in the back. Okay, now we need to bring our last character. I'll do the same thing with this guy as well.
The most dangerous people in society.
Yeah, now if you look at it, it looks quite similar to the reference. Now we just need to add a couple of elements at the end and we should be done. So the first element is this fire, which comes on the screen by, look here properly, it fades in with a little bit of flicker. So we need to do that. I downloaded this fire animation from Action VFX. They had this in one of their free preset, so you can download it from there, or I'll just add it in the description as well. Let's put all this layer above and drag it below here. Yeah, it should start from around here. It should go till the end. First of all, let's just go to the FS control panel and adjust the scale and position of this properly. I also think that the color of the fire is a bit too similar to the color of the character, so it's overshadowing the character quite a bit. So we'll go to the FX tab, search for HLS. It will bring the color balance HLS, bring it over here, and if you go to the FX control panel, we can change the hue a little bit to the orange side. Yeah, if you give it orange, it should be good. So if you increase the hue value, it should turn a bit orange. Now since it is just a short clip and it is a looping one, we can just copy this one by holding alt and dragging it. We can create a couple of copies so that it lasts till the end, and just cut it over here. Now we need to fade it in with a little bit of flicker. So for that, I can just select this clip and go to the opacity here, start a keyframe, go a few frames forward, maybe till here, add another keyframe. Now go to the first keyframe and do it to zero, and in between we'll add a bunch of keyframes with random values, like one should be a bit low, the other one should be a bit high. All of them should have some random value so that the flicker. Yeah, but just make sure that the first one is 0 and the last one is 100. Yeah, you'll see that the flicker is happening. And now at the end, you can just right click here and add a default transition. Maybe they increase the length or something so that it fades in while flickering. Now, let's see the reference if we have anything more to add. Yeah, except the fire, you'll see that there are some text, this sleeping thing ZZZ floating around. So we'll need to add that as well. So for that, we can just press the type tool, click here, add 3 Zs. It should be below everything, and just drag this out. It will start a bit later, the fire, later to the fire. Yeah, it should start around here. So now we need to play with it a bit to match it with our reference. So for that, we'll go to the captions and graphics tab first and change the font to something different. I think this will work fine. You can choose your own font, doesn't really matter, and just decrease the spacing between the fonts. I'll place it over here somewhere. Here, now if you go to FX and search for this distort. If you search for distort, we can add this lens distortion effect to here and change the just unselect this fill alpha thing and change the values a bit, maybe, Maybe you can change the position value as well here. Just play with these values, you'll get something which will work quite good here. Yeah, this looks okay for now. We'll need to add another effect over this to animate it slightly. So in order for that effect to work, we need to nest it first, because both the lens distortion and the other effect will not work together. So let's nest it and add this turbulent displace over it now. Now we'll go to the first frame, decrease the value. Let's keep it zero at the beginning. Add a keyframe, to the size as well, and go till the end and change the amount to something like this, and maybe the size also something like this. You can play with the values to have some slight animation. Yeah, press ease in and ease out this to us, this keyframes as well. So now if you look at it, it has this slight animation. I think this should be fine. Just keep in mind that we are doing all these things in Premiere Pro and not in After Effects, so we'll have to adjust in some places. But yeah, it doesn't look that bad. So now the last thing we need to do is add a Gaussian blur. Add this Gaussian blur over the ZZZ and increase the value a little bit. 20 should be fine. And let's look at the animation now.
The most dangerous people in society are lazy, ambitious people.
That's it. If you want me to make a tutorial for this in After Effects, I'll do that as well. Just leave a comment below, and yeah, if there are enough comments for this, I will make a After Effects tutorial as well.